Hello friends, I welcome you all for GD&T Learning Together. I am thankful to all the viewers and subscribers for amazing response. Today we are going to understand one more interesting topic. What are the rules of GD&T? The agenda of our discussion would be to understand what is rule number one, what is rule number two, and how to break these rules, and points to remember related to the fundamental rules. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them. I'll be glad to answer them. All these rules will study in accordance with ASME Y14.5-1994. Rule number one, or limit of size. Rule number one states that when there is only a size tolerance is given, no other tolerance is given, the variation of size and variation of form is controlled by the size of tolerance. Let us examine this with a case study. Consider a cube of 20. Here individual feature, consider width of 20 plus or minus 1. The first part of rule number 1 is variation in size. Let us examine what is this mean in this case. Tolerance of size is 20 plus or minus 1. So upper limit will be 21 and the lower limit will be 19. And second part of the rule is variation in geometric form. That means variation in straightness, flatness, circularity and cylindricity. This rule is also known as envelope principle. Further, we will understand what are the other parameters in this. We know that there are two parts for the limit rule number one. One is variation of size and second one is variation of form. Variation of size, we understood that the variation of size is controlled by the size tolerance of the feature of size. Variation of form, there are three cases. The first one, perfect form at MMC. That means when part is produced at MMC, the form should be perfect. That means the circularity, straightness, cylindricity, flatness should be perfect when part is produced at MMC. When the actual size moves from MMC to LMC, the variation is allowed. The amount of variation is allowed equal to the difference in actual tolerance to the size tolerance. The third scenario is when the part is produced at LMC. When part is produced at LMC, no perfect form is required. Rule number two. Rule number two is related to material modifiers. When there is no material modifier specified for the feature of size or to the datum, the RFS applies. Let us examine this considering three cases. Case number one, look at this feature control frame. Now, the tolerance zone is specified at MMC, whereas datums are specified at RFS as per rule number 2. Second scenario, the position tolerance is specified at LMC and for the datums it is at RFS. When there is no material modifier specified, in that case it is considered as RFS by rule number 2. How to break these rules? The one is straightness control applied to feature of size. That case, rule number one doesn't apply. And second is by specifying the note in the drawing, perfect form at MMC not required. These two cases, we can override the rule number one. Points to remember. Rule number one does not control location, orientation or relationship between the features. Rule number one does not apply to stocks such as bars, sheets, tubing, structural shapes, etc. Rule number one does not apply to parts subjected to free state variation. That means flexible parts. For further information, refer to ASME Y14.5-1994. The next session I will be planning on different usages of position tolerance. I invite you to subscribe the channel Add Wings to Journey of Learning. Thank you for your time.